about if you played the game on the Taurus? Taurus, what are the... You say then. So, let's start with an easy case. So let's start with the Taurus. Start with n being 1, n being 2. Could you guys play this game with yourself to work out how many moves are there? See if you can calculate what is n in this case.
Поиграйте the same subway and not
so same rules, but now you're on a Taurus.
Почему тот же ответ не может подойти?
А то у вас есть возможность еще соединять. На плоскости у вас какие-то штучки, какие-то вот эти ростки могут быть не соединены, а на торе есть
там
лишний путь.
Однозначная игра получается.
А? Однозначная.
На торе же можно сыграть так же, как на плоскости.
Нет.
Да, можно так сыграть.
Ну выходите, покажите. Он для этого и сказал вам поиграть самому с собой.
Да, это сложно.
Это не сложно.
Очень сложно.
Просто не надо рисовать кривыми эти линии. Вы сами себя запутываете.
Сейчас.
Вам прямых отрезков вполне достаточно.
А когда они пересекаются на торе, а когда нет?
Они на торе пересекаются тогда же, когда и на плоскости.
Почему?
Еще раз, вы все, что должны помнить, это про лифты. Вот он разумно нарисовал вам квадрат. Надо понимать, что вот есть лифты, которые мгновенно перевозят вас с одной границы на другую. И все. То есть тор – это реально вот этот квадрат с системой лифтов.
Ясно.
Я могу поиграть.
Давай.
Nice one. Two. Three. Five.
Ты можешь...
Нет, нет, вверх опять.
Нет, наоборот, это горизонтально.
Тоже хорошо. Вот теперь очень интересный вопрос. На что разбился тор этими линиями?
Максим, I have a question for you. What I'd like you to do is to shade in with different colors all the different faces.
Лучше пронумеруйте. А нумеруйте, числа пишите, будет лучше.
Numbers. This is first. This is first. There's one.
Mm-hmm. Очень хорошо, дальше.
Now, each of those spaces, topological, so this space here is a surface. What is the name of that surface? What do we call it? Because of D. It's a disc. Disc. That's a disc. This is a disc. Is the yellow number ones, is that also a disc? Because remember, this is connected to here. It's connected to there. It's connected. So that's one. That's another disc. And this is also a disc. So let's observe that. Each face is a disc. So compare that with, if I have a torus, and say here is a face. Is this a disc?
No.
Is this a disc?
Yes.
Почему это?
No.
Первое действительно диск, а второй нет.
The second is torus with a cutout.
Okay, and can you think of what that? So yeah, we have torus and you cut a disc. And so what? So how can we tell this isn't a disc? So what's?
Как сказать? Как доказать, что это не диск? Нужен путь, который не разрезает его. Можете указать такой путь?
Вокруг единицы.
Почему он не разрезает? Как раз вокруг единицы разрезает. Горизонтальную линию проведите, которая не пересекает единицу.
Let's look at this picture and compare this interior with this.
Кто-нибудь?
Это вокруг дырки.
Да, покажи горизонталь просто проведи или вертикаль, лишь бы не пересекала единицу. И скажи, что она не разделяет его.
And so what's special about that circle you drew?
It doesn't divide the torus with the
passage.
Коль, объясни, что две точки над желтой линией на рисунке можно соединить, что они в одной компоненте. Не equal, а в одной компоненте.
It's connected. Yes, very good. So the Jordan curve theorem doesn't apply to that face, if you like.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So, if it were, as opposed to in this case, if we drew any circle in here, then we know it separates into two curves. And again, that's by that Jordan curve theorem. Okay, so very good. Excellent. Now, so if you have such a, say, a graph on a torus is connected with no two edges. So if a graph is connected and has, and again, no edges cross except at vertices, and you have this property that each face is a disk, and each face. Then we have our formula applying. Can anyone guess what this will be? In the case for a sphere, it was 2.
5a.
Нет. В эйлер характеристика тоже чему равна, помните?
And what is the Euler characteristic of a sphere?
2.
2. So for a torus, what might we guess this number be?
Для тора.
0, 0.
0,
yes.
So 0, so that's the Euler characteristic.
2 минус 2, помните?
Okay, so if you have a graph on a torus, but it's really important that you have this property. It's automatic for a sphere, but you don't necessarily have that for the torus, as we saw. Okay, but I won't prove that now. Maybe we could look at proving this perhaps next week. But if we have this formula, then maybe we can work out a formula for M. Like Nikolai did before. So I just wrote, this applies to any surface, M, so that if you have a graph on a surface, so that the faces are disks, then the vertices, number of vertices minus number of edges plus faces is the Euler characteristic of the surface. So given that formula, let's look at our original result again. So given this formula,
Ребят, все понимают, откуда она взялась, вот эта формула. Потому что когда у вас граф разрезает поверхность на диске, то фактически вы получаете диаграмму склейки. А для диаграмм склейки у нас как раз и определялась Эйлерова характеристика.
We were looking at, I want to make this clear. We proved this theorem. When our vertices were precisely the vertices of a gluing diagram, and the edges were precisely the edges of a gluing diagram, and the faces were the face, was the one. Okay, so here we're looking at something more general. We're looking at a graph on the surface, as we had before. So here we've got vertices that aren't necessarily these vertices. Okay, so that's why this is it's not true. We haven't proved this yet.
Про склейку скажите. Про то, что мы разрезаем поверхность на эти куски и склеиваем.
We cut along these circles and we have many gluing diagram.
Uh-huh.
Of circles and we have already proved for them.
Okay, well that's not. Would you like to explain it to me?
When we cut,
каждый граф порождает диаграмму склейки.
If we have a graph
we can make a green diagram of this graph. And for the, we have many circles. What this is a circle. This is a circle and this is a circle. So, and we can make.
Разрезаем поверхность по ребрам.
We cut the surface along the edges and get and we will get.
Получаем много кругов, много дисков.
Many disks and for them we have already proved the formula of the LA.
Okay, so for each where that number is 2, is that what you mean? So for each disk you have some graph. So if you cut off your graph, you have a little graph here, and for each of those graphs you have this formula applying. What is this number?
What is a graph inside a circle? We have cut it along all edges. You mean?
I misunderstood that statement. Then I thought you were cutting along each face. You've tessellated the surface into a bunch of discs, cycle.
Ну мы разрезали поверхность на диски.
Нет, у нас был граф, и мы разрезали вдоль всех ребер.
У нас была поверхность.
У нас была. We have a surface and a graph.
Yes.
Then we have cut it along all edges, and so we have some disks and a glowing diagram.
Okay.
And for the disk?
Well, the disk you approve. Okay, and the vertices of the disks are the vertices of the graph.
Yes.
And the edges of the disks are the edges of the graph.
Yes.
I see. And we approved it for. And okay, so each is a gluing diagram. I see. Okay.
Какая у него характеристика?
Почему? Ну, мы считали вообще-то единица. Но это сейчас как раз совершенно не важно. Ребят, важно, что он вам написал задачу на доске в центре.
So let me summarize what you just said. So proof was in. So you start with a graph and a glowing diagram in, with the property that every face is a disc, then cut along all the edges. Martin's example. Cut along all the edges but when you cut remember that these are glued together, so that's glued to this, that's glued to this, and so forth. So and label. Cut along the edges and label. So on the other side, what I mean is, remember that when we cut, we could cut the surface without changing if we remember that we glue back. So you cut along the edge, but then you remember that you glue back. Is that okay? Yes.
Разрезаем по ребрам, но помним, то есть отмечаем значками, что их склеиваем. В результате поверхность не меняется, а получается диаграмма склеивания.
So remember you take a surface and you cut, but you remember that you glue them back together. Okay, and so then when you do this, as Maxine was saying, you get some big gluing diagram, so that the edges of the gluing diagram are precisely the edges of your graph, and the vertices of your gluing diagram are precisely the vertices of the graph. And we already proved that for such a gluing diagram, this formula applies. Then the vertices, faces of the gluing diagram. This gluing diagram. Then face the vertices, edges, faces. And we proved when. So here where the vertices are the vertices of this gluing diagram. Edges are the edges of this gluing diagram, the face of the face of this gluing diagram, which happen to match with the ones on the graph. Is that okay, Nicola?
Yes.
Okay, well, excellent. So now we have this formula. So we can return to the question of how many moves are there in a game of Brussels sprouts on a torus or any other surface. Oh, that was my question. N crosses. In a game ball. What is number of moves? What is n? So earlier we have for when n is a sphere, n was 5n minus 2. Okay. So my question is, what if you have another surface? Can we find out what is formula here? So when the Euler characteristic was 2, we had 5n minus 2.
Это 5n
минус 2. Доказательство надо. Надо выйти вон к той доске и сказать, чем будет формула отличаться.
Нет,
надо выйти к доске. Оля, выйдите к доске. К доске выйдите и покажите, вот что там.
Окей.
Двойку замените на хи.
So, there will be many changes, like, oh, change here to here or error characteristics. There will be also error characteristics, and there will be also error characteristics.
That's it. Formula is fine.